it, we can able to convert all the work into heat. Like W can be the entire W. Like if you are send, if you are giving 50 kilojoule of energy, that 50 kilojoule of energy can be converted into entail into heat. Okay, but when heat is convert, when you want to convert heat to work, when you want to convert heat to work, I can't convert. If I'm supplying 50 kg of heat, means I can't convert the entire 50 kg to 50 kg of work, 50 kilojoule of work. Okay, so when heat is converted to work, Q is always greater than or equal to W. So Q is greater than W, which means therefore work is high grade energy, okay, and heat is low grade energy. You got it right. High grade energy means which is like from work, if I'm giving 50 kilojoule of energy, I can get 50 kilojoule of heat. Okay, I can able to convert it. But if I'm giving you 100 kilojoules, 100 kg of heat, if I'm having 100 kg of heat, means I can't produce the entire 100 kg into a work. So which means this guy work, he is some kind of high quality guy. So which means work is like high grade energy, and heat is low grade energy. Keep that in mind. Okay, work is always high grade and heat is low grade energy. The complete conversion of low grade energy into high grade energy of a cycle is impossible. Okay, which means a completely conversion of a low grade energy, which means like heat into a high grade energy, is impossible. You can't convert the entire heat into a entire heat energy into a work energy. Okay, so second law talks about everything about the quantity and quality things. Okay, because first law is nothing but law of conservation of energy. Energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. It is converted from one form to another form. You know that first law tells about energy conversion, okay, law of conservation of energy. But in second law, it tells about how much the energy is converted, the quantity and quality of that energy. So those kind of things we'll be seeing in the second law. Okay, so let me have a cyclic heat engine. Okay, this heat engine can be anything. It may be a internal combustion engine. It may be a boiler. It can be anything, any system. Okay. It may be a gas, that means internal combustion engine, or steam power plant. So this is like from the power plant producing the work, right? Whatever it is. So the thermal efficiency is nothing but work done divided by total heat input, which is nothing but W net by Q1. Here, W net is nothing but, suppose if it's a power plant, means the work of turbine minus work of pump, that is the net work. Okay. From turbine, we can able to get the, already I've given, I told you, if work is taken from the system, it's positive. Work is given to the system means it is negative. Okay, similarly Q, this is work. Similarly Q, if it is taken from the system means like negative, Q is given to the system means positive. This is sign conversion. Okay, if a power plant, okay, we can get the work from the turbine, right? We can get the work from the turbine, so WT is positive. Similarly for heat pump, okay, heat pump or pump, okay, here we are giving the work to transfer the water from low level to high level. So here we are giving the work. So this work is negative work. So WT minus WP is equal to Q1, which tells me that Q1 minus Q2 is equal to, so W net in otherwise is nothing but Q1 minus Q2. So this is the efficiency of system, guys. I'll teach you this in a more elaborate way in the later part. Okay, don't worry about that. So